Yeah, I mean, I didn't know because we had such a wide-ranging weather report. And we had went through all this stuff before the game, and it was concluded that it probably would not rain heavily until at least 2:15. It might rain, but not heavily until around 2:15, and then that got backed off. So in the beginning there, we just, everybody was staring at each other, but we went for it, and it actually worked out really well, obviously. Give Jason credit, man. He pitched really well under awkward circumstances with weather. Gives up an early home run, settles in, not unlike what Johnny Lester did the other day. Outstanding, plus he gets another big hit. How about it? So another good day for Jason.
Joe, take us through the eighth inning where you end up with Wood versus Meeks and versus Alvarez.
Yeah. And I felt really good about Stropey coming in there. I mean, it's a really perfect setup for him. Tomas, Ahmed, Horn, etc. And when he gives up the leadoff home run, but then there's a hard hit ball at second base, then there's a leading punches, then there's a hard hit ball. So I just didn't think he was on his game today. Cahill's a ground ball pitcher, just to see if he can keep Goldschmidt on the ground. Walk. I did not want Lamb hitting. Did not want Lamb hitting. So I thought they might pinch hit. Have not seen enough of Weeks to know where he's at physically. I also know that I like Travis on righties. So I thought that was the better matchup. We got lucky. Weeks worked a great at that. But also give Travis credit for throwing that strike right there. There's a lot of people don't even understand that part of it. So we got through that. And then, of course, the jug run with Anthony was huge in the bottom of the eighth. But that was it. I just didn't see a good outcome with Stropey today right there based on the previous hitters.
Joe,